me, a woman like 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 me.
Rick wants to hire me. He's at a new studio.
Where is it?
India.
When? I don't remember what year. There's no year. How do you know there's a year for that?
I think they say the 14th century.
The 14th century was recently.
No, but I don't know. That's,
that's when the Mughals were ruling. Babur was in India.
Okay, 11th, 10th.
It's definitely B.C. It's B.C. for sure. And I think it's Ayodhya.
And
where Ram was born.
And Sri Lanka.
And I know that because they raised that temple. They said that Ram was born there. Then, which I don't believe, but that's what they say.
And Ayodhya is in the state of Uttar Pradesh. It's right there. Therefore, the story has to be true.
It's probably based on as real as event as the Bible is based on.
You want to know the whole story? Oh, because Ram's father had four wives.
Four sons, three wives.
Okay, I know the names of the sons, by the way.
Kausalya.
Yeah. No,
that was the wife. That's what I meant.
So, but
Kausalya, Sumitra, and Kaikeyi. And Kausalya's son was Ram. Sumitra's son was Lakshman. Kaikeyi's son was Bharat.
So impressed.
And Shatrughan, I think, was Lakshman's brother, which means he had to be Sumitra's son. Sita was Ram's wife.
Right. And Sita, I know also, came. Sita's father was Janak.
Sita has many names. Sita only being one of them.
Yeah.
Janaki also.
I'm representing the RSS.
And I saw a
Vaidehi.
Play. Huh?
Vaidehi.
I saw a play called Vaidehi, right, which I learned there was another name for Sita.
Rama was about to be crowned by Dashrath as the king, and Kaikeyi went to him because she had done something really good. I think she had taken care of him when he was really sick or something like that.
Yes.
And so at that point, he had said to her that, you have one boon, or anything you ask of me, I will do. And so she went and asked him to send Ram away for 14 years, thinking that was a long enough time that if you go away for 14 years, you're pretty much out of sight, out of mind.
Thank you.
Rama, my son, today I wish to crown you king of Ayodhya. But my evil, scheming wife, Kaikai, just reminded me of an ancient vow I made. To honor this vow, instead of crowning you king, I must banish you to the forest for 14 years. Goodbye, dear boy. You are noble and good, the embodiment of righteousness, a brave warrior prince.
Don't let the door hit your ass on the way out.
That's what she asked for, and Dashrath was heartbroken. But he died. Given that all Indian men are true to their word, he had to do that. If that is your wish, father, I shall go. Yeah. No, and he went. And Sita said, if you go, I go.
No, Sita. The forest is beset by Rakshasa demons. They harass our wise men and desecrate their ritual fires. I must fight them alone.
I will accept any hardship. I cannot live without you. I cannot live without you. I cannot live without you. I cannot live without you.
I'll miss you.
It's only a 6-month contract. I'll be back before you know it.
Ravana was the evil king of Lanka. And he just stole Sita.
But he was an incredibly learned man. From what I understand, Ravana was... Actually, the only bad thing he seems to have done is capture Sita, like kidnap Sita, which is kind of interesting because like everything else about him seems to be like he's this really learned guy. He knows all these weapons. He plays to the right gods, I guess.
What I'm really impressed is, you know, that he was a king of Sri Lanka.
Well, no, he was a king of Lanka.
Huge. It was Lanka.
Well, some people would...
Ceylon. It's the same country, I think.
Well, the point is, that's what we think.
They build a bridge.
The bridge still exists, so NASA images say.
Really?
Yeah.
NASA?
NASA says all the satellites.
It must be true then. Maybe it's not when they were on the moon.
Surpanakha is the one with Surpanakha. The really ugly.
Surpanakha, but she was Ravana's sister.
Ravana, Rama has slaughtered your rakshasas in the forest. You must take revenge.
Don't do it, master. Rama is powerful.
Sister. Do not bother me with your petty concerns.
Dear brother Ravana, have you seen Rama's wife, Sita? She is the most beautiful woman in the world. Her skin is fair like the lotus blossom. Make Sita your wife, Ravana. Steal her from Rama.
Don't do it, master.
I'll hear no arguments from you, Maricha. You must help me at once. Transform yourself into a beautiful golden deer to distract Rama. While Sita is unguarded, I'll grab her. Sita will be mine.
What a beautiful golden deer. Oh, Rama, won't you capture it for me?
I don't know, Sita. It could be a trick.
Oh, Rama, please.
All right, Sita.
What wouldn't I do for that man? He's not an angel or saint, and what's the odds if he ain't? With all his faults, I know he'll get by. I'll be so true to him, he'll never doubt me. What wouldn't I do for that man? For when he let me lean my weary head on his shoulder, wish I never grow older. I'll never leave him alone. I'll make his troubles my own. I love that man as nobody can. I'm just no good when his arms are about me. What wouldn't I do for that man? Oh, what wouldn't I do for that man? Troubles my own. I love that man better than I do myself, man. That's all.
But you know what Sita does then? How she actually is able to tell these people where she drops her jewelry along the way, right?
Right.
And that's how they were able to find it. It went all the way up to Lanka.
How many times did she drop the jewelry?
she had a lot of jewelry in the forest.
She lost jewelry.
I mean, no. She's not wearing any jewelry because she left everything before right. She left Ayodhya and she came.
Oh, she left everything.
Yeah, she did.
Right. She just came in her sannyasi clothes.
She's gone. I told her not to leave the hut. Oh, how will I ever find her? Sita! Sita!
And so Hanuman was actually born with the sole purpose of eventually meeting up with Ram and helping him. Like, that was the reason for his birth.
Oh, Sita, what has become of you?
I will help you.
Who are you?
I am Hanuman, the monkey of warrior, son of the wind.
I am Rama, prince of Ayodhya. Let us be allies.
I shall be your servant forever.
Now go, find Sita.
It's me.
Dave, where are you?
Trivandrum, silly. At home.
You have a home phone?
Of course.
You've been gone a month and you never emailed me your phone number.
I didn't? Well, I have some good news. They've extended my contract another year.
What? Another year? You said you'd be back in 6 months.
But I like it here.
What about me? What about Lexi? What about our apartment? What about us?
Don't cry, Nina. I love you. You could come here.
She sits under a tree.
And she weeps. And, all
and
these
thinks of Ram. And praise to Ram.
And all these evil people, you know, all these movies and all these shows we've seen, and all these evil people come and sort of scare her, and she prays to Ram.
But I think the thing is that, the women, whatever, the women, demon, whatever, were supposed to protect her, are amazed by her
devotion
to Ram. And so Ravan also comes in and says, what can Ram do for you, blah, blah, blah.
That I can't,
but she still, Ram will come here, and you still have one last chance, because once he comes here, you know, your ass is grass.
I love you, Sita. You must be my wife.
Never. I love only Rama. I am the chaste and virtuous wife of another man. I belong to Rama as the rays belong to the sun. Give me back to Rama, or you shall soon hear his mighty bow that resounds like Indra's thunderbolt.
The more a man speaks sweetly to a woman, the more she insults him. You have 2 months to decide, lovely lady. Then you shall share my bed. If you do not marry me, my Rakshasas will slaughter you for my breakfast.
Your ugly yellow eyes should fall out of your head as you stare at me so lustfully, Ravana. The only reason I do not reduce you to ashes with my own blazing power is because Rama has not ordered me to do so.
Sleeping in bed. If you were peeping, you'd find that I'm weeping instead. My loving daddy left his baby again. Said he'd come back, but he forgot to say when. Night after night, I'm crying. Daddy, won't you please come home? Daddy, won't you please come home? I'm sorry. Awesome. No one can fill that vacant chair. Home isn't home when you're not there. No need to know, the door is open for you. Sweet daddy, even the clock keeps ticking. Daddy, won't you please come home? Daddy, do you have to roam so very long? Yet, but I'm liable to weaken. Daddy, daddy, won't you please come home?
She also made her own share of mistakes. In fact, she should have just gone back with Hanuman. The whole idea of my man has to come to save me. It's like, oh, you know, one little tight thing. Jump on the monkey's back, go back, chill out. Hundreds will be fine, okay?
Is it possible that she didn't trust the monkey altogether?
It is possible. It is possible that she didn't trust the monkey.
Hanuman, assemble the monkey warriors. We shall cross the sea to Lanka and rescue Sita.
Yes, my lord. We march at once.
Knocking. Don't stand outside there. Come on in here. Who's that knocking at my door? I've been waiting oh so long. I'll just die if I'm wrong. Who's that knocking at my door? I know it can't be the mailman, the coal man, the ice man. They've been here today. Can't be the grocer, the butcher, the baker. They don't knock that way. If my sweetie's there outside, my arms and my heart are open wide. Who's that knocking at my door?
Ah!
Me, oh my, my, oh me, guess I'm having company. Who's that knocking at my door? See the time, it's 8 o'clock, sounds like a familiar knock. Who's that knocking at my door? I know it can't be the milkman, the gas man, the bread man, who always collects. I hope that it isn't that butter and egg man who writes out those checks. If it's my sweet, you to be gonna lock him in, lose the key. Who's that knocking at my door? Can't be the plumber, the peddler, the porter, cause I paid those bills. I hope that it isn't the doctor, the dentist, they can't cure my ills. If it's someone that I've known, gonna make him feel at home, then who's that knocking at my door? That door.
Dan dan takete takete dadri kritete takata gedi gina nage 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 tete kete dadri kritete takata gedi gina dan dan takete takete dadri kritete takata gedi gina nage 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 tete kete dadri kritete takata gedi gina dan.
Dave! Dave!
We're in India. No kissing in public. Let me take your bag.
There is a power.
Well, here you are. Good night.
Later, I know what he did. What did he do when he saw her in Lanka? Hug her and kiss her.
No, I don't think so.
No, I don't think so. He was very cold.
Why was he cold to Sita?
You have lived in another man's house, so you are unfit to be my wife.
What?
I have done my duty in rescuing you from the enemy and avenging the insult to myself. I have terrible suspicions about your character and conduct. Ravana was aware of your beauty. He cannot have kept you in his house for so long without touching you. The very sight of you is painful. You are free to go wherever you want. I have no more use for you, Sita.
If I had known this, I would have killed myself before and spared you this war. Build me a funeral pyre. I cannot bear to live. Despite my virtues, my husband has rejected me.
He's obviously doubting her, her pureness.
I find the whole pureness thing really odd.
I find it really weird that nobody is commending Ravan for not forcibly... I mean, I know we shouldn't commend somebody for that.
What if he raped her?
Yeah, but in terms of villains, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we expect villains to be villainous.
Yes.
This is a guy that's like, if you don't come to me willingly, I will not touch you.
Right.
I will not force you in my house.
Right. You're mean to me. Why must you be mean to me? Me, honey, it seems to me you love to see me. whole day through. Why do you act like you do? You're mean to me. Why must you be mean to me? Oh, gee, honey, it seems to me you love to see me crying. Please tell me why I stay at home each night when you say you'll phone. You don't, and I'm left alone, just singing the blues and sighing. You treat me coldly each day in the year. You always scold me whenever somebody is near, dear. It must be great fun for you. Can't you see what you're doing to me? Please tell me why.
And he's still not convinced, it seemed like, after she went through the trial by fire. I mean, it's almost like...
No, but I thought he was convinced. He then, it was peer pressure later with the washerman.
Yeah, because the washerman, because...
He was convinced. It wasn't like he doubted it. He kind of was like, okay, you are pure. And I think he did hug her and then flowers fell from the heavens or something.
Whoops. I guess you are pure after all. Will you forgive me, Sita?
Of course, Rama. I live only for you.
Hey, they want me to attend this meeting so much, they're gonna fly me all the way to New York. 5 days, all expenses paid.
That's great. It'll be fun for you.
See you next week.
No, it's a flying chariot somehow. The gods sent a chariot. I don't know, something about... I found it to be totally cool. It was like the world's first airplane or something. It was like the first... Like, they actually flew back. I don't think it was on a bird. Was it on a bird? I think it was actually a flying thing of some kind.
They were in a carpet like Aladdin.
No, it was like an elaborate structure.
Pushpaka.
That's what he came back on, the flying chariot.
Pushpaka Vimanam.
That was one of the Air India jumbo jets also.
Correct.
And there's a movie, a silent movie.
But that's what I mean. It was like this thing. It wasn't a bird.
Pushpaka
Vimanam.
Right.
I guess what is happening is 14 years were finishing off, so they had to find a quick way to get back.
Look for brighter weather or watch for the sun again. If you want the rainbow, then you must have the rain. Pull yourself together, whistle a happy strain. If you want the rainbow, then you must have the rain. So if your lucky star deserts you, and if shadows fall, even though it hurts you, laugh through it all. Be a cheerful loser, you have the world to gain. If you want the rainbow, why you just must have the rain.
That's all.
Rama, I'm pregnant.
That's wonderful, darling.
Maybe they joined the Mile High Club.
Yeah, on the Pushpak Viman. We don't know exactly when she got pregnant.
Very soon thereafter, which is why it's conceivable that someone could argue that love, that she wasn't pregnant because of Ram. But I think it was Ram.
Blasphemy. It is Ram.
Yeah.
But that happens with the dhobi story.
Oh, that happens with dhobi. Yeah, there is a dhobi story.
Yeah. You know the dhobi, the
right.
Yeah, the dhobi says that.
Yeah.
That some, one, the dhobi's wife.
Wife is
with somebody else. And when she comes back, he goes, what do you think, I'm Ram?
I'm like Rama.
To take somebody back in the house after she's been
with
another
man. You know
the
dhobi is, right? He's a washerman. Right?
And when the news of that hits Ram, Ram says, I cannot rule if my subjects don't respect me.
Right.
And so you'll have to... Actually, that's when he banished me. Sorry.
Say, Sita, would you like to take a chip?
But we just got here.
Yeah, great. Get packing.
Brother Lakshman, my wife's dubious reputation casts doubt upon my own. You must drive Sita to the forest and abandon her there. I cannot have her in my kingdom.
I think basically as a king, he had to sort of do, if the common man was doing that to their wives, then why would the king treat his wife any differently kind of a thing?
Like I felt he let her go, not because he thought she was impure, but because he said that to be a king, he needs the respect of his subjects.
Right.
And he can't be considered.
Well,
I don't think he let her go because she was impure.
I felt that he always had this element of doubt. I mean, it coupled with, of course, you know, his virtue that everybody spoke of, and you know that he kept his word to his dad, and then his subjects, his kingdom. But I felt like he always had this doubt that she might not be pure.
Make my troubles double with his worries when surely
I deserve a love none. Moan and love, my sweet man is gonna go. When he goes, God sees he's a man, then he's a woman, just like me.
Have committed a terrible sin in a previous life to deserve such suffering. Were I not carrying Rama's sons, I would throw myself into the river.
She's always shown to be pregnant. When she's banished and she's gone into the forest again. And, you know, there she meets that teacher.
Valmiki,
sorry.
So that's how Valmiki wrote the Ramayana, because Sita told the story to him.
I'm just a woman, a lonely woman, waiting on a weary shore. I'm just a woman, but only human, one you should be sorry for. Got up this morning, along about dawn, without a warning, I found he was gone. Why should he do it? How could he do it? He never done it before. Am I blue? Am I blue? Ain't these tears in these eyes telling you? Am I blue? You'd be too. If each plan with your man done fell through, was a time I was his only one, but now
anyway, so Lav and Kush were born to Sita in the forest and were actually taught by Valmiki, who taught them how to sing all these songs praising Ram.
Love, Kush, let us sing the praises of Rama.
Rama's great, Rama's good, Rama does what Rama should. Rama's just, Rama's right, Rama is our guiding light. Perfect man, perfect son, Rama's loved by everyone. Always right, never wrong, we praise Rama in this song. Sing his love, sing his praise, Rama set his wife ablaze. Got her home, kicked her out, to allay his people's doubt. Rama's wise, Rama's just, Rama does what Rama must. Duty first, Sita last, Rama's reign is unsurpassed. Rama's great, Rama's good, Rama does what Rama should. Rama's just, Rama's right, Rama is our guiding light. Perfect man, perfect son, Rama's loved by everyone. Always right, never wrong, we praise Rama in this song.
Take me back, please, please, please. I'll do anything, please.
If you had a girlfriend who was being treated really badly by, like, her ex or by her current boyfriend or whatever, and she kept saying, no, every day I'm going to make sure I cook for him and send him a hot lunch at noon, aren't you going to turn around and be like, listen, he doesn't like you, he doesn't talk to you, you've got to move on. Something's wrong, okay? Sita's doing this puja every day. I mean, I feel once again with this whole good and bad thing, that we always want people to be either all good or all bad. I think Sita also has got her own issues. Like, she didn't go back with Hanuman. She could have saved hundreds and thousands of people from being killed.
Monkey especially.
Yeah, what about animal rights? And then she prayed for this guy every day. Come on.
But also at that point of time, it was just that unconditional love, you know, for her. She was like, okay,
I think this is the part of the female perspective that I disagree with. Because it's like, then we can say, oh yeah, because she loved him, so she did this. You know, it's like, yeah, but she shouldn't love someone who doesn't treat her right.
Who treats you so badly.
Okay, that's her mistake.
That's hence unconditional love.
You went away, I left. We broke the ties that bind. I wanted to forget you and leave the past behind. Still the magic of the night I met you seems to stay forever in my mind. The sky was blue and high above. The moon was new and so was love. This eager heart of mine was singing, love of where can you be? You came at last, love had its day. That day is past, you've gone away. This aching heart of mine is singing, lover, come back to me. When I remember every while I'm waiting here, this
When Ram was in the forest, he heard these two boys singing. He didn't know who they were, but he came up and he was just like, who are they? Who are you? And that's when he finds out that Sita's there and those are his children.
My sons!
Father?
Return to Ayodhya Palace to rule with me for eternity.
But then, he wants to take Love and Kush back. But he's still hesitant about taking her back.
Sita? Well, yes, of course. Sita. All Sita has to do is prove her purity again. Another trial by fire, perhaps. Or we could try trial by water. You know, see if she sinks or floats. If she sinks, she's pure. If she floats... No, wait. If she floats, she's pure. If she
sinks... And he asked her to prove her purity one more time, I think. No, actually, I don't know about whether he asks her or whatever, but she says...
I shall prove my purity to you. If I have always been true to Rama, if I have never thought of another man, if I am completely pure in body and soul, then may Mother Earth take me back into her womb.
Nobody else but you. You caught my eye, and I've got a feeling I'm falling. Show me the ring and I'll jump right through. I used to travel single, oh, we chance to mingle, oh, now I'm a tingle over you. Hey, Mr. Paulson, fallen for nobody else but you.
Thank you.
song is ended, but the melody lingers on. You and the song are gone, but the melody lingers on. The night was splendid and the melody seemed to say, summer will pass away, take your happiness while you may. Beneath the light of the moon, we sang a love song that ended too soon. The moon descended, and I found with the break of dawn, you and the song had gone, but the melody